Have you called your mom recently? Mother's Day is coming up. Whether it's your biological mom or a mother figure in your life, go call your mom right now. Go do it. I'll stand here and wait. I'll still be here. Pause the video and go call your mom. Now that we've gotten that out of the way, moms are so important in our lives. We need our moms. Like I said, whether they are our birth mothers or mother figures, we need these women in our lives. And there's one very important mother figure that we need in our lives too. Of course, I'm a Catholic priest, so you might be able to guess who I'm talking about. Of course, it's the Blessed Virgin Mary. We need this important mother in our lives because she is mother to us all. Mother to the church, mother to the nation, just as we saw earlier today when Archbishop Gomez from Los Angeles reconsecrated the nation to the Blessed Virgin Mary. Mary is all of our mothers. Or I should say, Mary is mother to us all. Sometimes this devotion to Mary can be misunderstood. Well, why don't we just go straight to Jesus? But we are going to Jesus because Mary went to Jesus. Everything she did was for him. And of course, we have prayers that are directly to our Lord. But what better way to get to know somebody than to get to know their mother? And true devotion to Mary necessarily leads us to Jesus Christ. So we need that devotion. Now, one particular way in which that we can cultivate that, of course, is the Holy Rosary. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, has challenged us this month of May, the month of Mary, in which we set aside the entire month to special devotions, such as the May crownings, the consecrations, the rosary to the Blessed Virgin Mary. He's asked us to get back in touch with this beautiful prayer of the Most Holy Rosary, recognizing that the Holy Rosary isn't about mindlessly repeating Hail Marys. No, it's about meditating upon the life of Christ. First, I'll say I'm not going to do a walkthrough of the rosary. Many websites exist out there. I'll put some links in the comments. If you don't know how to pray the rosary, I'll put a couple of websites, not in the comments rather, but in the description. But when we pray the Holy Rosary, we meditate upon these mysteries. We're not just mindlessly repeating Hail Marys. Because people will use scriptural. Scripture says, you know, to not pray mindlessly with needless repetition. We're not doing that. No. As we pray these Hail Marys, we're looking to these mysteries of salvation history. Through the joyful mysteries that we pray, that we meditate upon while we're praying the rosary, we remember the early life of Christ. We remember the Word made flesh. We meditate upon Mary's yes to the archangel. In the luminous mysteries, we remember those pivotal moments in the life of Christ that gave glimpses into who he was. Moments such as his baptism in the Jordan River or the Transfiguration. The institution of the Eucharist. In the sorrowful mysteries, we look at his passion and death, and what those mean for us, that him sacrificing himself saved all of us. And in the glorious mysteries, from his resurrection onward, we meditate upon how we have been given new life, how we have been made church by the descent of the Holy Spirit, and upon the special place that Mary has in our lives. The Holy Rosary is all about the gospel. True devotion to Mary is all about Jesus Christ. And so, during this month of May, let's follow our Holy Father's suggestion. Let's have a deeper devotion to Mary through the Holy Rosary. If you're not used to praying it, you know, maybe not a whole rosary, but maybe just pray one decade, 10 Hail Marys, meditating upon one of the mysteries. Or if that's too much, maybe just 3 Hail Marys. But let's cultivate that devotion within our hearts. Some people find it hard to pray the rosary, to just sit down or to kneel and pray it. I'm going to be honest with you. I hardly ever do that because I can fall asleep very easily. And so what do? When I pray the rosary, I go out for a walk, much like this one. In fact, usually after these little videos I make, I pray the rosary because that works for me. Find what works for you in order to cultivate this devotion, to get back in touch with this excellent and wonderful tradition of the church. And so this entire month, we dedicate to the Blessed Virgin Mary because she leads us to Jesus Christ. That's all there is to it. And so, my friends, I look forward to hopefully seeing you all soon. Please continue to pray for me as I pray for all of you. And may God bless you all. And may we see each other hopefully very soon as we're starting to enjoy the fruits of spring on this first month of May. This new life, spring coming forth. And especially remembering the new life that our Lord Jesus Christ has given us through his passion, death, and resurrection. God bless you all, and talk to you soon.